It's like Melbourne's been fed steroids in the last 10 years as far as the live music scene goes.
I think why Melbourne works as a music city and certainly the rock and music capital of Australia is because culturally we're the most diverse city in Australia.
Melbourne's always been like the music mecca of Australia. It's just more live venues, there's more bands, there's just more talent down here.
There's definitely a richness of artistry that comes from Melbourne, and it's definitely spreading around the globe.
And this city's always had a huge reputation for, you know, not only harnessing great talent out of the city, local talent, but also celebrating artists that come from other parts of Australia and the rest of the world.
Melbourne is such an incredible melting pot of creative types.
People like Vance Joy come out of Melbourne. When we've had people like Gozier and the Temper Trap, I mean, there's definitely a feeling that Melbourne is a city that's happening, it's a city that's vibrant, and it's a city that makes great music.
We're very lucky in Melbourne to have an incredible infrastructure when it comes to educating. We've got 15 tertiary courses which support music business, which is unparalleled nationally.
So how fitting is it now? We're going to encourage people to come to Melbourne worldwide and learn the craft from here.
There are opportunities here to start your own business, be an entrepreneur, you know, like myself, start a management company. And 10 years later, I'm still here and I'm still working.
We've got an audience that wants to go out, that wants to explore music and check out new things. We've got the promoters here. Most of the major promoters live in Melbourne, so a lot of music and the concert industry is generated from here. And we've got strong, vibrant record companies based here who are always looking for new talent.
They all kind of feed into each other. Venues, community radio and musicians, and a lot of people move here for that.
In fact, we've got the most venues per capita compared to any other city in the world.
Something about Melbourne and Melbourne artists that seems to be sort of putting the spotlight on us, which is really cool.
Now at the moment, you've got a lot of great acts coming from Melbourne because you've got an incubator here.
It's amazing that was possible, you know, I was able to do something here that got onto an Eminem album.
To have the government support to be able to travel, travelled over to Toronto, was able to perform at Canadian Music Week and then come home and actually get some more government support to finish off the record.
Melbourne Music Week is another great example of watching the city celebrate one of its big passions.
This hasn't just happened in the last 10 years, it happened back in the 60s when we had
the Seekers right through to today with Courtney Barnett and everything in between.
You know, America definitely is keeping an eye on what's happening in Melbourne.
Melbourne has cemented its reputation as the music capital of Australia, if not the world.
Just believe in the Melbourne music industry. Just believe, because you won't go wrong.